seen a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle with their opponents.
And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Columbus's offense just about ready to go again.
Carry by Henderson to start the drive, and he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver, but he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up three on that carry.
The throw over the middle, taken in.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Now a handoff. Henderson, and nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down.
Early down stuffs have put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. He finds his man complete. It's Fleming.
People worry about throwing the out route because often it can get jumped, and that can turn into an either an incompletion or an interception. But not on that one. Everything came together, and he catches it and goes over the sideline.
So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. He takes this for about six down inside the 40.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
The last run got six, now second and four. Off the play fake. Stroud going for the deep ball, and that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
An early message that this secondary is going to be tested, because even though it fell incomplete, it almost felt like a warning shot to get things going.
Now they face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. Looking to throw. Stroud. And oh, that nearly an opening drive INT, but it does fall incomplete. Not the way he wanted to start this ball game, as it brings up fourth down. So now they're going to send out the field goal unit to, as they say, fire away from long distance. This will be from 56 yards out. They were probably hoping to get him a little bit closer for a shorter field goal, but he was able to get it done from deep.
Nice little tester for him to begin things, huh? I think he was open for a little bit more of a chip shot. Instead, they made him stretch it out a little bit, but he's got to feel great now that he put it through the pipes.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Taking it about the one. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. Our visitors getting set to take over on offense. They go play action here on first down. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
But they certainly came out firing in this one, and while that one was incomplete, I can't imagine
here now is second and 10. Back to throw. Finn. That's complete. He's got Barkley out of the backfield. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
On third down, Finn. Oh, not sure he saw the linebacker there as that's batted down and incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
And they'll send out their punter now as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. A 40-yard punt, no return, and that will come the offense as they take over. Back onto the field comes this offense, ready for their second drive. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put 6 on the board here. We'll see. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
Well, a lot of credit to the play caller here. He saw the design in his mind and implemented it. A little zone stretcher here because they started the tight end on the left side of the formation and sent him on a crossing route. And this works really well when you can find that space between levels, and they were able to do so for good yardage.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Looking to throw. Stroud. So the pitch and catch good for 11. And they'll be faced with a third and inches.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Henderson will try and run for the first, and he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first.
They had yet to run the ball at all on this drive, but third and short definitely was a great time to dial one up.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. This is Henderson. Bust through the tackle. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
And now some motion before the snap. And this will be our first penalty of the night's proceedings. A false start penalty, and now they're back to needing 10 yards on second down. From the gun, Stroud. Throw right side, going to be taken in by Henderson. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. That'll leave them with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. Out of the gun, they give to Henderson. And he gets this down to the 18. Good enough for a first down. Now, after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. They had to settle 3 last drive, hoping this second go around ends in 6. In good position, 1st and 10. That is caught at the 7. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7.
And coming into this ball game, this was an offense that wasn't just talking about the notion of ball control. They were preaching it. They want to win the time of possession battle, and they've done so here. This drive's taken up quite a bit of the first quarter. Now they are set up 1st and goal.
And it's caught. Touchdown. A great play there. There to make the grab. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. On those slants, everything happens so quickly. What makes it work?
The timing between the passer and the receiver. In this case, a slant route ordinarily is probably about 3 steps before you go on the slant. In this amount of time, I think it's a 2-step deal. Boom, put his foot in the ground and got inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass, got inside for the catch and the score. So an early 10-0 lead for them now as they kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And he won't quite make it to the 25. Back onto the field comes this offense, ready for their 2nd drive. They'll look to get something started. They need to, down 10-0 early as they've got it 1st and 10. Maneuver his way forward for about 4. 2nd and 6.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of 1st downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
Flushed out right. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. The lane opens up that time as he'll be brought down just short of a 1st after a gain of about 9. Well, you're down early. How do you get back in the game? Maybe establish the run. I think they're trying to do that.
Now, I'm with you on that one, and what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offensive coordinator, let's run the football, let's get things settled down a little bit, and find our way back into this game.
And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up 3rd down.
Well, that one was all about the defender making life difficult for the receiver. Very tough for a guy to hold on to the football through all that contact. He ends up forcing the incompletion.
They tried the throw on 2nd down, unsuccessful. Now it's 3rd and 1. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40.
I have to admit, I'm excited by that play call and the end result, because this is a team that's down big early in the first quarter, and a lot of teams will just panic, abandon the playbook, and just start firing the ball all over the place. It's way too early for that. Stick to what works for you.
Down double digits, and we talked about their game plan being both running and passing there. You're right. They're sticking to the game plan, getting the ground game going.
A lot of football left to be played.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good 1st step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Another 2-yard gain there, but they'll need to do better this time. It's 3rd and 6. This is no ordinary try here. This will be from 56 yards out. And he missed it. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10 at the 39-yard line. They go over the middle, and it's complete to start the drive. They showed off a nice juke of the defender before the next wave could bring him down. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so. Off play action. Stroud. He's got a man. It's his tight end. That's complete.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Back to throw. Stroud. Escaping the pressure right. He's got the first down here inside the 30. And he takes it all the way down to the 22.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
He'll decide to keep this once more. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. 10-0 the score after one on EA Sports. Second and 8 coming up. Looking to throw. Stroud. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then, of course, they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play, and that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
Touchdown! An 11-yard touchdown. And his guys are going to add on to their lead. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
Extra point right down the middle, and that makes our score 17-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. So here are visitors to take over on offense. And they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team, because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. But let's face it, we've been there. We've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out?
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. From the gun, Finn. And this throw incomplete. Well, the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down.
Well, it's easy to see when we review this that the ball needs to come out quicker, because if you don't throw it right on the break, you bring a crowd of people into the equation.
And that's why it got knocked away there. The offense on third down tonight, just just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. And Charles, this infraction is going to be against the offense. False start.
Sometimes you have to get up to the line of scrimmage, make sure your team is set before you begin your cadence.
So the false start certainly doesn't help matters as they'll try again now. 3rd and long. Back to throw. Finn. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
As defensive coordinators around the league tell me all the time, that throw is not for every quarterback because you've really got to drive the ball downfield. It's going to be a tight window for him to fit that one into. In this case, unsuccessfully.
Now on 4th down, on is the punt team sending this one away. And he'll take it just outside the 40. 33 yards is the distance on the punt there. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Columbus's offense just about ready to go again. They have to be pleased with the way that they've moved the football thus far.
And why wouldn't they be? 2 touchdowns on a field goal in their first 3 possessions. They're playing so well right now, the field goal probably feels like a disappointment.
They'll run with Henderson here to begin the drive. 5 yards is the tally on 1st down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. Off the play fake. Stroud. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
They run the option here on 1st and 10. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. Give him 4 yards there on the 1st down keeper.
Typically on the read option play, when we talk about responsibilities, we're talking about what the quarterback has to go through. How about the inside linebacker, though? His job on this play, shadow the quarterback and hold him to a short gain. Did it to perfection.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a 3rd down and 6. When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot, he had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play. A lot of deflated looks on that defense. It seems like they just cannot find a way to get a key stop on 3rd down. Here's another conversion. And now this offense, they're in a position to go up even further as they've got it 1st and goal.
So not quite a 1st and goal. It's 1st and 10 from the 10. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
The way he's been slinging in the first half, you expect everything he throws to go for a touchdown. But I guess he's going to have to wait to try and pick up that 3rd, isn't he?
Yeah, I thought he had him for a 2nd, but you're right, not to be. They'll go again here from the 10-yard line on 2nd and goal. Throwing again, Stroud, and a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
Nice play there to force the incompletion, and to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches. And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far, but on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
And for the 2nd time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. And his kick here is good. And the lead now increases to 20-0. No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. If they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
one away. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. Our visitors getting set to take over on offense.
And still no points on the scoreboard. You're coming off of the three and out. They're just looking for anything to grab onto right now, aren't they?
I'm wondering if someone's going to take charge in the huddle. You know, we always look to the quarterback, but sometimes it's another player on the team, a star, a veteran, someone with some excitement and energy. It's like, all right, guys, let's shake things up and let's go, because they still have an opportunity to make things happen.
Shake it off. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him the football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are. You know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a third and four. Looking to throw, Finn. Boy, that's a 5-yard loss. Fourth down now. And on now is the punter, as he'll come on to kick this one away. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Columbus's offense just about ready to go again. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put 6 on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. Give him 10 yards on the keeper, and it'll lead to a second down.
Well, partner, for a few years there, we thought this read option play was going to take over the whole NFL. It seemed like everyone was using it. But it has been scaled back considerably in the last few seasons, mainly because people worried about their quarterbacks getting hit. But when you call it at the right time and you use it properly, you see the type of gains you can get. A nice chunk of yardage there by the quarterback.
So that was all you're looking for on a play like that. Get the first down and keep the drive moving.
Yeah, it just looked to me like he just said to himself, I've got this. I'll take it. I'll pick it up and let's keep moving. Get the first down, get a new set, and let's start over.
And now the ball's out. Fumble near midfield. And the defense will get their hands on it. Going the other way. And his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 47. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. And to give this time to the tailback. He'll get 3 up to midfield.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
The offense on third down tonight, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 8, and that is incomplete.
They went with the dive look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
So they bring out their punter. He'll boot it away from about his 35. And a fair catch called for and made just outside the 15-yard line. It's just a 30-yard punt that time, no return. Columbus's offense just about ready to go again. And a fumble last time. Ball security. Talk about it all the time in the National Football League. They've got to be better at it on this drive.
Don't you think that when every team gets together for the first time, I don't care if it's OTAs, mini camps, first day of camp in the regulars.
He's got a man complete. And he takes it all the way down to the 32. And they rattle off a big one.
Every defensive staff harps on limiting explosive plays. Job not so well done there.
Yeah, they talk about it all the time. A lot harder to stop, though, isn't it? And when you think of an explosive play, most offensive staffs define them as passes of 20 or more yards and runs of 15 or more yards.
They went zooming past that number there. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down.
Well, he is certainly dangerous when he spots a lane, and he keeps it himself there. Worked out well.
And how about the moving parts on a play like this? You know you have to practice it over and over because it's almost like a ballet that has to be choreographed. But how about once he made the decision to go, he committed to it and went. Let's face it, most teams are going to defend the running back much more than the quarterback on that type of a play.
Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight. 8 yards to go on second down. From the gun, a give to Henderson. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. Another 2 yard gain there, but they'll need to do better this time. It's third and six. 2 yards on the first down carry, and then followed up by 2 yards on the second down carry.
Well, that's definitely not going to be enough to get the job done. Wasn't the expression 3 yards in a cloud of dust?
Now they're going to need six on third down to keep the drive going. And he's going to be taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And his kick is indeed good. And that will up the score now. It's 23-0. So he's been a busy man here in this first half. That's three field goals for him now.
And not just three field goals, but three for three. So even though the offense has struggled a bit putting it in the end zone, he's still been able to come away with points due to his leg.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. So here are visitors to take over on offense. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Flush to his right. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. He gets it forward for four, maybe five, but the flags fly. And this one could be coming back.
Our visitors getting set to take over on offense.
These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
Give him 9 yards on the second down screen play.
And some play callers, when they go into games, they don't mind calling a lot of screens, and they don't care what down. They were maybe one block away from really having something there to start this drive. Good job defensively to cut through the blockers and make the tackle on the screen, or that could have gone for maybe 15 or 20 yards.
Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
On first down, Finn. He's got his man. It's Andrews. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
Now, that's the kind of big play you'd like to see. This first half, it hasn't gone their way, and they could use a shot in the arm, something to perk them up a bit. And they get one here in the passing game.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. They'll look to throw again. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
10 after the incompletion on first down. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. He'll get this out to Barkley complete. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. Now another timeout called for by the offense as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime. Again, he'll drop to throw. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up second and 10. Back to throw again. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 38. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. He's going to look downfield for Barkley. And this almost intercepted. Not sure he saw the free safety that time. But lucky, incomplete. That'll bring up fourth down. And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. This officially a 55-yard attempt. So we've come to halftime after a very one-sided beginning to this one. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! Fielded just outside the goal line. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. And this offense set to go now to begin the third quarter. And you have to think, Charles, down three scores already. They need to play an almost perfect second half to have a solid chance.
And that absolutely starts with finding some way to put together a touchdown drive here. They need to be smart, fast, efficient, get the ball into the end zone, and do it again multiple times in order to have a chance to win this game.
5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Second and 5. From the shotgun, it's Stewart. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. They follow up the gain of 5 by only getting 1 there on second down.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on 3rd down. Now he's going to go deep down the left side. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 18. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Henderson now on 1st and 10. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. 46 yards on the ground for him so far.
Partner, I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking when those big behemoths start to create space for you up front. He did a pretty good job of just following those guys through there for a nice explosive run.
And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. A second down play results in a loss of 2 yards.
Well, he's had success running the football in this one. Yeah, that's undeniable. But that time, the defense was on to it.
And, partner, I think the more you see a play like this, the more they're able to diagnose it quicker and easier for them to defend it. I think you have to dress it up a little bit and show maybe some different formations and looks.
And he is not going to get the first down as he'll spot this at about the 28. He'll get a couple of yards on the keeper, but it's going to lead to a 4th down. They bring their punter out there now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. 39 yards on the punt, just 2 on the return. So here are visitors to take over on offense. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
Now, Brandon, that's the way you want to run the football. There should almost be quote bubbles above the offense right now. Bam, boom, biff. That's how they feel good about moving the football.
They'll keep it on the ground. Low. Call it a gain of four there, so it sets up a big play here. Third and a yard.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he brings this up to the 46. Good enough for the first. Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on third and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
And he's going to be down at the 35, gain of 7.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Now a man open down the middle of the field, and they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25.
But look what we have here, a sustained drive, and that was certainly AWOL in the first half. They really struggled to try and move the football, but right now they certainly seem to have the formula working. Let's see if they can keep it up.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, 1st and 10. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. Here's 2nd and 10. To throw again, Finn. And he comes back with one complete. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
The 8th play of the drive coming up. It's 3rd and 3. And he'll have the first down, getting this one to the 14-yard line.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
Nothing in that first half, nothing on the last drive, but they're moving now with a 1st and 10. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. A gain of 2 there on the heels of a 1-yard pickup on first.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
To throw on 3rd down, Finn toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs, able to knock that one away on 3rd down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected 4th down here.
Now on 4th down, out comes the field goal unit here. And his kick is good. And that'll get this back down to a 20-point spread. So the 3 points there, and CD, that helps him inch a bit closer.
Yeah, partner, when you're losing, any points you see go on the board in your favor, you're happy to take them.
taken at about the one. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. Columbus's offense just about ready to go again.
They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage. Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man.
And now a fumble. The ball's out. It's going the other way. And he'll return it to the 24-yard line. Following the fumble recovery, Finn. Give him nine there on the first down completion. Looking to throw on second down. Finn. He finds his man complete. That's Andrews.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Back to throw. Finn. A dump off here to Stewart. Down to the 6-yard line on a pickup of 6 as he gets halfway to the goal line.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Eluding the pressure right. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
A couple extra tight ends in the formation here as they line up third and 2. Blitz coming, and down he goes. It'll be a loss of 8 on the sack, and it's going to lead him to fourth down.
Well, he shot in, CD, like he was out of a cannon from that linebacker position. And even though they had a running back in the backfield, no one could stop him.
Well, you certainly diagnosed that play perfectly, because as fast as he got into the backfield, you're exactly right. The running back had no shot to get over and try and protect his quarterback, and a sack resulted.
So they wind up turning the turnover into points as they convert there for 3.
Yeah, that was a nice job there to force the fumble. They recover, hand things over to their offense, and then the offense went down and got them 3. That alone, that's not enough to win a game, but both units able to do their jobs on these last 2 drives.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. Columbus's offense just about ready to go again. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though, when they only gave up the field goal? And they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive. A little more pep in their step because they didn't cost their team a touchdown. But they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
The coach will just be relieved, though, if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think coach would be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield and punch in the end zone without turning it over.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. Looking to throw. Stroud. That catch good for 5. It's 3rd down. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his 3rd down play as we've played 3 quarters. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The offense on 3rd down tonight, 3 for 7 so far in this game.
They need just a yard here. It's third and one.
And they'll try and run the option to pick it up.
Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up fourth down.
Just a simple run play there on third and one, but this D was up to the challenge and stopped them, bringing up fourth down.
On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. That's taken on the 25. A 40-yard punt, 5 yards on the return.
Our visitors getting set to take over on offense. Even though they were able to force the punt defensively, still a big hole to climb out of, especially at this late stage of the contest.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Throwing to start the drive. Finn, and that one off the mark behind him, incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Back to throw. Finn throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete.
Well, the trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen, despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game.
On third down, Finn. Going right side here, and that's complete. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down. Did they maybe play that too safely on third down? I know you don't want to just throw a ball blindly downfield, but that didn't help them a whole lot.
I think they probably said if it's open, take the shot. If not, get something safe because we do have fourth down to try and pick it up.
Now they go for it on fourth, but this one is going to wind up incomplete.
Columbus's offense just about ready to go again.
Been a very strong performance for them, really, on both sides of the football. The turnover on downs, the most recent example, and now, obviously, they're in a great spot here.
Yeah, if you're over on the bench right now, you're shaking hands with your teammate, you're hugging him, give him a little dap. Been a big, big performance for them. Now you just don't get careless, take care of the ball on the way out.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
59 yards rushing for him in the ball game now on 14 carries.
Now I think we can get used to seeing more of that in this fourth quarter, especially if they're having success on the ground like they did there.
Yeah, I think back when we met with the head coach in preseason, and all he talked about was building a bully. And I think it was this situation he was envisioning, trying to ice a game, plenty of time left, but being able to give the ball to his big runner and pound away and try and finish off a game. Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
Trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down. Switch it up here and look to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
And it's caught. Touchdown. A great effort there. His second touchdown of the night. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And now before we get to the extra point, remember all touchdowns do have to be confirmed by the replay official. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end.
just the feet. How about the hands? How's the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
Point after, right down the middle. And the lead is now 24. Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. So here are visitors to take over on offense. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. Decent start to the drive, but let's face it, they need a lot of things to go right in a short amount of time, down 3 scores.
Yeah, they're going
to
run their 2-minute offense here in this game, but this is for future games. Can they get better and be ready for the next time, hopefully with a chance to win?
Meanwhile, the throw here is complete. And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves them with 2 to go on second down.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10, as they've got things rolling on this drive. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked out and incomplete.
Well, it just seems like all game long there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page, quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the same grease board when you draw plays up. They haven't been on the same surface tablet that you look at on the sidelines. Nothing's worked for them. They've got to find a way to start matching each other's movements.
And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. Looking to throw, Finn. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
And look, they got it. Good for them. But they were within his range. I know that would have been a long field goal. I'm kind of surprised he didn't kick it, though.
I guess what he's going to have to do is frame it as, I just had so much confidence in the offense there, that's why I went for it. It's not me saying, you couldn't have made that field goal. I'm going to need you later. Stay ready.
Yeah, he did have the one miss earlier, but you're right. Stay ready. There's still plenty of time in this game.
Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage.
Here's second and a yard.
Back to throw. Finn.
Well, not sure he saw the linebacker there, as that's batted down and incomplete.
At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them, because just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the
production there, it's going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10.
And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete.
7 yards to pick up there. From the 6 now on 2nd and 3.
Looking to throw. Finn. Bynes. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. A 6-yard touchdown run. And his guys are able to close that gap just a bit.
I wonder if he changed anything on his play sheet or they just executed better. Because they had 2 previous drives that ended in field goals. Before this one, they finally were able to put into the end zone.
Well, and it's intercepted at the goal line. Good positioning, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. And this one won't bounce their way. It's covered up by the hands team. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical. Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
On second down, here's a keeper by the QB.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a third down.
Well, for that being an option play, there really weren't too many options available for him, were there?
No, there weren't, and at least he was able to get back to the line of scrimmage, so he didn't lose anything, but you're exactly right. Nowhere to go.
To throw on third down, Stroud. He's going to look deep down the field. And it's caught. Touchdown. A great play there. 42 yards. And his guys are going to add on to their lead.
You have fun with this one, partner?
I am. I mean, he's been fun to watch under center.
We always talk about, you know, getting to the next level, right? When we see people get into the zone. This guy's in the master class right now. What a performance he's putting on, just carving him up.
4 touchdown passes, carving him up is right. Seems like everything he throws is going to be a completion and going in the end zone. The extra point splits the uprights, and they open the lead up now to 25. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
No run back here, down to a knee, and this drive will start at the 25. Our visitors getting set to take over on offense.
And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield, and that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. And
fourth quarter here, trying to preserve the lead. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again.
Hit from behind, and he's going to be driven down. Call it a loss of five, a big sack to bring up third down.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
And that incomplete, nearly intercepted. And remember, he had his hands on one earlier, had one pick. Could have been a second, but instead it's fourth down.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. So possession goes over here on the punt.
Columbus's offense just about ready to go again.
And a few kneel downs should come very close to finishing this one off, depending on whether or not we see any defensive timeouts. They still have two, but using them would just be prolonging what's really already been decided.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at their own 46. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four, second and six.
Well, at the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Again, it's Henderson. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
Well, praise has to go to the guys on the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game, and while they slowed them down on that run, can they continue to do so? Because they haven't had much success throughout this ball game.
From the gun on third down, Stroud looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Henderson. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. So plenty of smiles for the folks here as they head for the exits. It's a victory for their hometown guys. And to be frank, Charles, probably not too many people surprised at how this one turned out.
Yeah, I don't think so at all. I mean, they're such a good football team. They were at home. You know, you walked in and you looked at the advantages and you saw that they had most of them. It'd take a lot to try and even it up. I just thought two words for this ball game: methodical and predictable. And both of them came together.